Okay.
So let's start or continue with where we left. We have discussed what is credit report date, what is credit reference number, right? And there are some other information as well that is also related to the credit report date and the credit reference ID. We saw that why we need credit report date, because to check the validity, you know, how long this credit report is going to be valid. Then credit reference number, yes, there are credit reference number that we always, if we need to repull credit report, then we can use this reference number and we can repull the credit report without paying any additional charges. Other than that, you know, the same reference number should be used by the PennyMe or PrettyMac, you know, AUS, whenever we are running that, so that they also can access according to this reference number, they are going to use the similar data in their evaluation of all the data, all the credit data, what we evaluated while doing the manual underwriting or manual review of the credit reports. Good. After that, there are few other information that could also be, that must or mostly appears on the, I would say, header of the credit reports, and that is not very much relevant to us, but we should always keep an eye on that. That is, this report prepared for who ordered the credit report, and a credit report ordered by report prepared for, so lender name, and then sometimes loan number could also appear, but those are not so much mandatory. But yes, if we are working for a certain client or certain working as a lender for some of the lender, obviously the credit report should have been pulled or should get pulled only with our lender's name, right? We should not use someone else's credit report which was pulled by someone else. So the credit report should always be pulled by our department, by our lender, for our purpose only. So that is the, all this information is going to appear in the very top of the credit report. Then on the following section, what information is going to appear and that we always need to check, then borrower information. Borrower, or when I say yes, S means multiple borrower, two borrowers, right? Borrower's information. Borrower info section, I would say. It has borrower name, right, and SSN number and date of birth and current address, this is going to appear under borrower info section. Current address and previous address. Right? Previous address is also going to appear on this section only. Okay, we should always cross verify all this information with our file document according to the guidelines that have been provided or they will be provided to you in the your process. But all this information appears here and we should always match. Now number four is the important information that we always need to check, that is the AKA information, also known as, right, there is a possibility in some format or for credit report which, you know, appearing here, could be AKA information could be at the bottom once the account information will be done. After that, it could appear. Some credit agency might going to, you know, write it at the bottom, or some credit agency, because it's not uniform, the format is not, you know, defined. It is according to the will of that credit agency, whoever going to provide us this credit report, how their format is. So AKA means also known as info means how many name the borrower is known as, right? So it could be like someone has a like J. Harris, right? J. Harris, and he could be Harris. He could also be known as Harris only. He could be J. H. Harris. So there could be different name, and could be J. Harris, and one more Harris, right? Or it could be spelling could be different, or it could be J H H. What we need to do, whatever the names written in this AKA section, borrower, we should always ask for a AKA affidavit, means also knows, or name affidavit, where borrower will be writing down all the names, these names, and need to sign that yes, these all names, you know, belong to me, or I am also known as with all these names. Okay. So that is the AKA information. And then there could be number 5 could be, you know, the FICO score. Or more sometimes it could be like repository information. What is the repository information? Repository information is like how many, you know, borrower, this is going to show the borrower name, SSN, and address, date, DOB as well, and the repository name means the Equifax Experian, what it available in the Experian, and then it is going to follow maybe Experian have to, you know, there could be two names that have been reported, or there could be two date of birth that have been reported to Experian. Sometimes people, while accessing the information, they might do some, you know, typo mistake, and because of that, two names are appearing there, or two SSN are appearing there, so both will be given here. And then in the similar way, like if there are three different records, those are available in the Experian, all those three records are going to appear in this repository section. And then Equifax and then TransUnion, all the records that are appearing for this borrower, right, those are related to this borrower, is going to appear in a sequence. So that is what the repository information. Okay, and then if there is something that we see is suspicious, or if we need LOX explanation, we can ask borrower to provide LOX for that. Are we clear on this till now? So we are done with AKA repository, and as I am telling, the sections are not, you know, uniform. It could be, it could base the sequence of these sections is going to depend on the format to format, website to website. If we are using a credit report from Credico, there might be possibility that after the borrower section, there could be like some other section which we are going to review, you know, afterwards. So if there is no such section, the only thing, if we know what need to be checked in the different section, whatever appearing, then we are fine with that. Okay, we just need to see what we need to review there. So AKA, so after repository, there is a possibility the next section was section number 5 or 6, right? So 6 could be like